Hello, I'm Gwen Yeo with the Stanford Geriatric Education Center. Welcome to our module on dementia care among Vietnamese American elders. We're very fortunate to have today as our presenters two experts in the field, Jane Nguyen Tran and Dr. Ladson Hinton. Ms. Tran is a social worker with Kaiser Permanente Healthcare in San Francisco, and Ms. Tran was also part of our research team with the caregivers in the Vietnamese American community. So as an introduction to the topic, Ms. Tran is going to describe the historical context of most of our immigrant elders in the Vietnamese American population.
Among the many results of U.S. intervention in Vietnam is the large number of Vietnamese refugees and immigrants who primarily fled to the U.S., France, and Australia. The literature regularly refers to their migration pattern as waves, which are split into three separate waves. The first significant wave of Vietnamese started leaving Vietnam following the fall of Saigon in 1975. Many of these Vietnamese had ties to the U.S. government or business. Identified as ethnic Vietnamese, were predominantly Catholic and tended to be fairly well educated and affluent. Those unable to leave met death or years of re-educating by the North Vietnamese Communist government, which reunited the country and did not view Western allied Vietnamese very kindly. As you know, this wave left under duress and the trauma of war. A large number of them settled in California, Ohio, and other areas of the U.S. formerly designated for their resettlement, and had the benefit of receiving federal assistance to help with learning English and enrollment in job training programs. You'll notice that I've made a point of putting on the slide that the first wave of refugees were airlifted or picked up by formal military sea craft. This is significant because starting around 1978, we start getting a large number of Vietnamese fleeing Vietnam due to the implementation of harsh restructuring measures designed by the Vietnamese government to make the lives of former South Vietnamese and American sympathizers, as well as ethnic Chinese, as miserable as possible. In this mix were the educated and connected, but the majority in this wave were the less literate merchants, religiously persecuted, or subsistence farmers unable to thrive under the new regime. These were the so-called boat people refugees who escaped Vietnam by whatever means possible. Because of the Khmer Rouge in Cambodia, this meant bypassing land escapes and risking the seas in hopes of finding friendly waters. The individuals from this wave who made it to the refugee camps of Thailand, Malaysia, and nearby countries were witness to horrible atrocities perpetrated against them by pirates. The pirates encountered by the second wave didn't take prisoners. They simply killed after raping and plundering, as many of the boat refugees had brought along as many possessions as they could manage. So for this group, in addition to persecution and displacement, there is the added factor of violence and threat of death, in addition to the stress of refugee camp conditions and acculturation. Our last significant wave of Vietnamese began coming in the 1980s. By this time, some formal efforts had been agreed upon to reunite the families of political detainees, Vietnamese expatriates abroad, and the children and families of American and European soldiers left behind after the war. The population from the previous waves were continuing to age, but this group of Vietnamese immigrants brought the largest influx of older Vietnamese. According to Immigration and Naturalization Services, 16,021 Vietnamese immigrants over the age of 60 settled in the United States between 1989 and 1992. By 1995, we had almost 42,000 Vietnamese greater than 65 years of age here in the States. So while there were over 500,000 Vietnamese in the U.S. in 1990, they were more than doubled by the 2000 census. And even though Vietnamese here in the U.S. are only 0.4% of the population, or 1.1 million, consider the fact that 58,000 of them were over 65 years old in 2000, and it is projected that we'll have about 4 million Vietnamese Americans by 2030, a significant number of whom will be aging along with the general population, and of a generation marked by low socioeconomic means and linguistically isolated.
The number of Vietnamese Americans has been growing very rapidly. both in general and specific to the older adults in the population. For example, in 2010, there were 126,000 older adults among Vietnamese Americans. By 2012, that number had grown to 150,000. So it's growing extremely rapidly. Then some other characteristics that it might be helpful to know is that almost all are foreign-born. That is, that most elders were born in Vietnam or in some cases in China. The other information that might be helpful is that most of the Vietnamese Americans actually live in California or in as secondarily in Texas. And there are a few smaller populations in some of the other states, including Washington State, Massachusetts, and Virginia. But important for clinicians to know about Vietnamese elders is that there are two-thirds of them speak little or no English. And this is based on the responses to the census in 2010. One-third have had less than 9 years of education, and in some cases have had none, no formal education. And 17% say that they live below the poverty, their incomes are lower than the poverty rate. So with that background, the next segment, Ms. Tran tells us a little bit about the belief systems of Vietnamese elders and their families.